with Iger, Sergeant. I think we'll have fun together. अगर हमें उसे पकड़ना है, तो we will have to make him rob again. When you ask someone to name the world's fastest creature, almost all of them think the fastest running animal, the cheetah. But if only you were to look upwards in the sky, you would see a blur traveling at a speed more than thrice this magnificent cat. Its abode is the sky, and it feasts the blackbirds. With chest muscles more powerful than a steam engine and body shell as streamlined as a bullet train, the peregrine falcon has been an inspiration to all of mankind's aviation efforts and to one secret project at Suzuki. Built observing the evolution of this single bird, truly built for speed. An evolutionary leap, a motorcycle like the falcon that can do 0 to 320 all day long. No pit stops. If you haven't heard the name Hayabusa, then you probably are not born yet. It did a good 16 kmph in excess than the Honda Super Blackbird, and thus breaking the 300 kmph barrier, became a legend that you didn't want barreling down in your rearview mirror. A benchmark set for a decade, or possibly even more, by its creator Koji Yoshihua, the Hayabusa had to be grotesque in every sense of the word. It had to look like nothing that people had seen before, and pack technology so far ahead of its time that it would go on to become cult for generations to come. Powered by the largest mass market engine of its time, pumping out a staggering 173 horsepower, the Hayabusa became the fastest production bike of the 20th century. It did not just make a statement, it set a precedent so bold that forced the Japanese four and European motorcycle manufacturers to get into the famous gentlemen's agreement, fearing an outright import ban. An informal pact to electronically restrict the speed of all road-going motorcycles to 300 kmph in the interest of public safety and to prevent the speed war from spiraling out of control.
In the Busa, the speed did not come at the cost of super sport handling, exceptional rideability, stability and comfort. In fact, it's this versatility of the hyperbike which makes it timeless. And 10 years on, in this 2015 avatar, the spirit of the Hayabusa has indeed endured. For this bike still rides like a charm. Its extensive wind tunnel design might not be the prettiest thing to look at, but that compounded with its lower center of gravity makes it a vicious high-speed predator. Yet, nimble enough to carve through the cityscapes. Its chunky mid-range is an apt reminder that this isn't a racing machine. It's an intercontinental ballistic missile. Fast and poised with high-speed stability that will make mile-munching a joke. Yet, it'll remain comfortable on the not-so-great stretches of tarmac. It's been 7 years since its last major update. In the midst of the current crop of superbikes, it has grown longer in its tooth to compete at the highest level. In 2013, it did get ABS and Brembo monoblock calipers, which made the beast more desirable and safer than ever before. But even today, bringing this juggernaut to a halt is quite a task, to say the least.
Still a workhorse on steroids.
Ready for any task that you ask of it on a paved terrain.
I'll do it quick. Lightning quick.
Like they say, heroes are remembered, but legends never die.
मचाया तू मचाया?
अरे हाँ अपन तुम्हारे साइड में, अरे वो देखा नहीं बाइक इतना फास्ट गया, उसी को तो पकड़ रहे हैं।
हाँ तो फास्ट तू मिले प्रॉपर है क्या? हाँ
अरे अली भाई बाइक चलाते नहीं बता दे
220 के स्पीड पे
बिना हेलमेट के, तुम्हारे बाप ने भी कभी गाड़ी उड़ाया क्या?